Now, first and foremost, you'll have to excuse the language on this one. I don't mean the swearing. I mean the actual language. I got hold of a ROM that said it was the world version of this game. And it seems to put it in a... I don't know what language it is. An Eastern European language, I guess. Which I don't understand. But hey, it's the game we're looking at. So we'll just put up with that rather than go downloading another version of it. Now... 2002. Clearly some kind of a hack. We'll see. If it's the same, I'm happy. I'm not sure it is. The music sounds different. Maybe it's not. So basically, the title for the best Batman game on the Mega Drive is a toss-up between the original Batman license, movie license, and this movie license. This is for Batman Returns. In my opinion, this is the best Batman game on the Mega Drive. And it's the graphics. It's all about the graphics. I think it's beautiful. It's a well-made platform game with gorgeous graphics. Not so great on some of the fights. I mean, was I within a meter of that guy? And also, I'm not seeing much of where I'm going. It's flawed in places. Quite badly flawed as well, to be honest. But it's still beautiful. Big chunky sprites, and big is beautiful. You will see where this game is flawed. First of all, it is meager on the animations, but the keyframes it gets in its animations are all that's required. Yes, it looks a lot better than it plays. It is slow to play. It is unintuitive in terms of where you're meant to go, but it's one of those games that once you get the hang of it, it's actually quite fun. And you can see the techniques, you can see the kind of the little routines these baddies have, and you've got to adapt to them. I just walked into them there, and this game takes a lot of that. Yeah, a lot of blind jumps as well. Sure, the palette's a bit dark, but it's all beautifully drawn. I love the way Batman's drawn. I love it. Oh, hello, yeah, I forgot about that. Big chunky Batman sprite with no energy. Oh, I'm gonna die, aren't I? I'm so gonna die. Come on, bats. Get up there. Oh, disappears into his cape. Yeah, I mean, don't get me wrong, it is really irritating. The baddies are so fast and nippy and difficult to just get hold of. And Batman is so slow and sluggish. But it feels like a deliberate choice. It really does. And I say, there's very few frames of animation to it all. But the frames they include, really, they get those frames right, you know. And I've forgotten where my bat rope is. I keep forgetting where my bat rope is. Because I am an idiot. But I do know that this game is one that, with a bit of practice, you really do get quite a way into. Mainly because I got quite a way into it back in the day. There's a lot of cheap hits while you're figuring out the lay of the land. Come on, bats. You big, beefy dude, yeah. You're proper beefy in this game. I remember there's a level in this game where everything, like the building's falling. Not falling, but it's kind of tipped. I just fall into my death. Nearly. I'm sure the bottom of the level is just below me. Yeah, the building's kind of tipped over on its side, you know, sort of 45 degree angle. And the whole level takes place on this angle. Maybe it's not quite 45 degrees. Oh, that's how you do it. The whole level takes place on this angle, and it's really weird. Uh oh. Oh, that was death. See, that was cheap. Because unless you know, you don't know, you know? There we go. Catwoman. Kick and burp, Batman. And this is very reminiscent of the Amiga version. I'm glad I wasn't talking on the Amiga version, because I didn't have to admit that I was involved with the Amiga version of this game. It wasn't a port of this, it was their own version. But when I was 15, I think, I worked at Denton Design in Liverpool. Now, Denton Design were, a powerhouse back in the day. They were one of those games companies that kind of were there at the very beginning, especially in the UK. Massively influential. And I got to do some work experience there as a kid. Well, for that, popping over my head. It's going to be close. I'm going to have it done. Oh, no, not. So close. Yeah, and they were very important, the stuff they were doing. Great Escape, Frank Hills, Hollywood, and all that. But by the time I hit the Amiga, they weren't quite as influential as the likes of Ocean. And what they did get was the Batman Returns license, but they got it quite late in the day. And I remember working there for 2 weeks on work experience, and they were on a very tight schedule to get the Amiga version of this game out. I say Amiga version, it's not the same game, it's the same characters. This scenario happens in the Amiga game. It is a 2D platformer, much smaller sprites, totally different style to them. Not in a good way, according to the reviews. But when I was a kid playing it, I was basically brought into playtest stuff, and I played it and outlined what I could see as bugs, what I understood as bugs. I'm going to just throw a batarang. Like, oh, she's battering me. Again. and one of the bugs I picked up was, back to the beginning. Oh, well, I'll play while I tell you this. One of the bugs I picked up was that the batarangs weren't very well drawn, and it was because the programmer came to me and said, well, you do better then. So I did. And I got to draw the batarangs in the Amiga version of Batman Returns. I was so proud. I'm dying to tell everyone. And then the game came out. Because remember, it was really hard to play. It wasn't great fun to play. And I thought they'd fix that. But deadline was that tight. But that was pretty much how it was going out. I was telling my mates that I was involved with it. And then it came out and the reviews came. And my God, it got battered. I'd say quite rightly, but I think it more so than it deserved. But then again, I played it a lot and got quite practiced at it and figured out a lot of how to, beat certain parts of it. But the main problem was it was just ridiculously hard and irritating and badly balanced. And quite rightly, it was because they had they didn't have long to make the game. And as I say, it was late in the day. It was not the best version of Batman Returns, I can tell you that for nothing. This one kicks the pants off it. The best version of Batman Returns, I'm told, because I've only briefly played it, and I'm inclined to agree with my experience of it, is the SNES version, which again is a totally different game to this. It's a brawler, and you know how I love a brawler. Apparently it's a very, very good brawler. In which you're able to like crack skulls together and stuff like that, like he does in the movie. I say apparently I have played it and it is great. I've only played it briefly. I do have a SNES now. I just haven't started buying games for it. I've got two games for it and now it's about Batman Returns. So I'm going to check that out. I'll probably check it out on this channel before I get around to buying myself a real copy of it though. The rate I'm buying myself games lately with the little babber on the scene. But yeah, I'm told, well I know because I played it, but I'm told by people who played it in more depth that it is awesome and it's, overall the best Batman Returns game. Although I do like this one, I'm not doing it much justice. I got a lot further back in the day. There's a lot more kind of variety and fun to be had with this game. And I remember the Mega CD version that my mate Steve had a totally different soundtrack, which was a big pull back then, but it's pretty this, Other than that, it was exactly the same game. Idiot! Come on. I'm going to beat her before I'm done. I'm going to throw these at her. Oh, she keeps... Oh, gotcha. She keeps weaving through them. Oh, look at that. Really? She's waiting for me to throw. I'm out of ammo. Right, it's punches and kicks time again. Come on, Selena. Down you get. want to knock off the building. I wonder if I get up. I think there's a technique to this. Yeah, there is. I remember. Use the platforms. I think it might be something similar with the Amiga as well. Anyway, I'm just playing the game now without talking to you. Good game this. Better than I'm giving it credit for. I've been meaning to buy a cart of this actually as well, which I will do at some point. It's about £7, I think, on eBay. Last time I looked. It might be more or less now. Yeah. But yeah, good game. Baton Returns for the, not the Commodore Amiga. Oh, look, there's that level. The Sega Mega Drive. If you've never played it, do check it out. Good fun. If not, slightly frustrating. Thank you very much for watching. I'm going to play a bit more.